This is a completely unique one-off production. Every aspect of it is from scratch, the staging, the design, everything from a blank sheet of paper.
When we started, we didn't know it was ahead. I think if we'd known, we would have been so scared, we wouldn't have probably done it.
There's something for everybody in the show, and it really is a journey to sit here and to see it all come together.
It's something that's supposed to be very Irish, very kind of spiritual, and something that's quite kind of earthy.
Well, Slain, for the recording of our new DVD, I mean, I think it's going to be incredible. I'm really excited, despite the fact we're still here in studio working away. Instead of a sterile TV studio or even a concert hall, suddenly you're out surrounded by Newgrange and the site of the Battle of the Boyne.
This whole area is steeped in mysticism, Celtic myth. The Boyne Valley is one of the most historic areas in the country, and this all felt a good match.
We've a production meeting here at the venue this morning, which is the first opportunity for all the various departments to meet for the first time physically on location.
So if we can just get an update from you guys as to where we are.
We go through all the emails and notes.
We turn the phones off just for a few minutes.
And we just sit around and work out exactly, you know, how to move the process forward.
It's something for literally to stand on with sheet music.
We're basically just going through a strategy of everything that needed doing, planning out the actual exact position of the stage, the modules the stage can be made out of, actually getting on the roof for the first time, because the last time I came here was actually just checking it out as a possible location rather than a definite location.
This sort of thing, I'm not even sure you notice that there's a corner.
You can come round more, because it gives a lot more space then, yeah.
A production like this does present its challenges. We're shooting outdoors in Ireland in August. We've had a tremendous run of great weather all summer, which is just starting to break. So there's a jeopardy factor.
We will all make it seem like it's under control, but I think deep down we'll be a bit nervous. Let's hope the weather stays fine. That's the big problem.
We finally arrived at Slane Castle. We got here 48 hours ago. As you can see, quite a lot of stuff has happened from a greenfield situation. One of the critical things about this as a production, and what makes it quite different and special, is that there's just a stage. There's no proscenium, there's no arch, there's no roof on the stage. We won't see any kind of lighting, we won't see cables hanging around. It's just going to be an orchestra, a band, a choir, and the girls. And that's what's going to make it look so special.
The show itself is a very interesting and new concept for Celtic Woman specifically. Our first release was done in the Helix Theatre, so obviously a more theatrical film set. Obviously, this time round for Celtic Woman and New Journey, we're definitely taking on a whole new spin by, you know, creating, you know, the set in front of Slane Castle. Using the castle really as the backdrop and as the feature. So all the lighting and all of the effects are being plummeted off this castle. So it really sets the tone for creating something very special, very unique and very memorable.
The choosing of this was done with no great science. This is the setting, as anybody in the music business will know, for some of the most historic concerts that have taken place in Ireland. We've been at the music business here for over a quarter of a century. We started in 81 with Thin Lizzy, fronted by the late Phil Lynott, then a not terribly well-known Irish band being U2. So this castle was built on rock and roll.
Declan Lowney, who's directing the project, he's an incredibly talented and well-respected director. He's also shot a lot of concerts. He shoots Glastonbury every year, which is one style of production, multi-camera, which is important. But also what I think he brings is he shoots a lot of drama as well.
At the end of A Holy Night, as the girl's walking off, handheld camera here.
He's very caring and sensitive about performance and emotion, and making sure to really get the most out of the performers on the stage.
My job really here is to shoot it and to make a half-decent job, hopefully, of shooting it. It's kind of camera placement, where to put the cameras. You're kind of setting a style for the whole thing as well, you know, how you'd shoot it. You shoot all the close-ups, you use a lot of wide shots. It seems to be about the girls and the beauty of the girls and what they're singing about, and just seeing this fantastic location.
Declan Lowney, the director, and obviously Ned, the producer, have been absolutely phenomenal on this project. From the start, they understood the vision, they understood what we were trying to achieve, understood that we were trying to be so genuine and close to home, and that this needs to be captured in the spirit that is Celtic Woman, and that it is very unique. There is nothing else like it in the world. There's not a sound like it, and there's not a visual.
Rehearsals for us are the time when all of the different work comes together. We're here in the studio, our choreographer Darren is working in the dance studio with the girls, and when we get to our dress rehearsal and, you know, our final rehearsals, all those elements come together for the first time. So everybody that's been working separately suddenly is working together. And I suppose that's when the sparks fly in the best sense and the really good stuff happens.
We're at an awkward stage now. We're halfway through the first day's rehearsal and there's lots of things not working properly and stuff like that. And we've had a lot of rain yesterday, so we weren't up to speed with things like the lighting and stuff. But we're getting there, and we will be there. It's actually quite a good rehearsal, you know, for a first day's rehearsal, it's gone quite well. We're about halfway through the set list, and really what we're doing is kind of, the cameramen need to know where the girls are standing, who's going where, who's going there, what camera's going to cover what. And so it's a bit of a voyage of discovery, but we've got another hour and a half of that before we break for tea. Okay. Then tonight, it's lights up and it's full proper dress rehearsal. But you kind of have to shoot the dress rehearsal as if you're not going to get another go at it, you know what I mean? Because tomorrow it might rain or the whole place might fall down or some bloody thing. It's always the other thing, when you rehearse something in daylight and then you shoot at night, it's completely different. You know, once there's lights and smoke and all that stuff happens, like, it'll look completely different. I think it's going to look great, actually. I've got very high hopes. It better look great.
Celtic Woman itself is basically six unbelievably talented women. The five vocalists, obviously, Maeve, Lisa, Chloe, Orla, and Hayley, and then Mairead, who is just inspirational and full of life on the fiddle, combined, take us on a whole new journey.
We have a brand new member of Celtic Woman, Hayley Westerner. Quite famous in her own right, who's also very excited about getting involved. And I suppose it brings another voice to, you know, in the mixture, in the ensemble, with all the harmonies.
Imagine we've got the cross, yeah. The pentagon, the octagon is down, yeah, the very end.
Yeah. I'm Chloe, I'm one of the singers of Celtic Woman. It's a great honour for us to make it to a place like this in Slane. We're filming our second DVD here.
Are you nervous?
No, I'm just more excited. Loads of new costumes and everything. Typical girls. I love the costumes. I pray we'll find your light
and hold it in our hearts. I like the whole idea of staging a concert outdoors in a beautiful place because you've got lovely things to look at. You know, so many concerts are shot in a venue, in a hall or whatever, and you're looking at a stage. And I actually genuinely like the show. I think these girls are great. I love what they do. I love the buzz. I love the chemistry between them on stage. So capturing that and trying to get that, all that intimacy on tape, that's what we're hoping to do tonight.
It's going to be dry, certainly from late afternoon the whole way through. The
place is going to be dry. It's fucking changing every hour, isn't it? Yeah. There's a little thing that PBS want to do. There's a pledge break.
Oh yeah, that. I thought you meant about the weather.
No.
You can see there's a few drops coming down, but we're not paying any attention. We've covered everything, and the covers will come off, and hopefully we'll have a glorious evening, and the lights are all coming on. It's starting to really feel very atmospheric, so excitement, prayers, and everything else will get us through, I hope.
When you do a show like this, the audience are critical.
Listen, my child, you say to me, I am the voice of
so they had to be coached in. They had to be wined and dined. And all of this is intimately part of the production. And it's critical at every show we do.
We're off to
do it.
Are you looking forward to it?
I can't wait.
Guys, while we have a few minutes, is there any lovely sky shots or things that you can offer us up and we'll actually roll to record on a few things just so I can get a few things down on tape? These are 90 minute tapes, aren't they? We're not going to run out of time.
No one is.
Average.
15
okay,
seconds.
We are recording, yes?
VDR roll.
Yep. Okay,
ten.
Thank you.
Okay,
Liz, 10
seconds playback.
I see it, Liz. That's great.
Seven.
Okay, folks, we're 10 seconds away.
Five,
I've got 12 cameras here pointing at the stage, so they're showing me a variety of different angles. So the shooting of the show consists of a variety of different things. You want sort of big wide shots to show you the location we're in and how magnificent and beautiful the castle is.
Sail away, sail away, sail away.
And then you use lots of close-ups as well, because the girls, you want to see them singing, you want to see their faces, so you shoot lots of close-ups. So it's picking a variety of cameras and camera angles, really, and then figuring out how we put all that stuff together.
I suppose the one thing that one always has an apprehension, particularly for a production like this, where there is a risk, and the risk, of course, is the proverbial weather.
Let's hold off on the next song, but why all these people moving about?
Sorry, Declan, looks like we've got some rain.
We had a bit of interruptions by rain last night, which is quite interesting, but because obviously the orchestra couldn't get their instruments wet, so they were going off periodically and coming back on again, which broke the show up a bit. But considering we didn't have any real rehearsal in darkness, I was quite pleased with how well it went.
But it's hard to love somebody that you're not in touch with daily, so I'm looking for somebody new tonight.
At least we have a show now. I think the biggest worry we all had was if it rained for 2 days, what were we going to do? But no, at least we definitely have a show now.
When you shoot a show for two consecutive nights, you would take the opportunity to change camera angles, but we didn't. We really liked what we were getting last night, and it's really just having the opportunity now from what we learned last night to get some more out of the lighting.
There's certain areas now, having seen the show, where I think that now we can afford to drop the level a little bit on the generally stage level and actually put sort of, you know, use the spots more tonight now we know the choreography.
Well, we got through the show last night really well. Everybody just came together and pulled together, and I mean, we really enjoyed it, I have to say. Just looking out was an incredible feeling to feel that it came together and we got to the end. Rained a couple of times, but I think we got a great show.
Then we come to something else. Franz, don't come out a bit on Chloe and you can do a little push in on her. Mixing four. There you go.
Tonight is the real thing. Last night we did the dress rehearsal, which went very, very well. Tonight, hopefully, is when we get it really, really, really good. Because it's a nighttime show, we need darkness, obviously, so there's a limit to what you can rehearse in daylight, because you see, it looks so completely different at this time of day.
The show has evolved over the last 2 years in an incredible way. When you look back to that initial shoot at the Helix in Dublin, followed by those first tentative tours of the United States, which ultimately did phenomenally, and the audience response throughout has consistently been incredible, both to the PBS special on TV as well as to the live performances.
Yeah, I'm just getting ready for the show, just trying to do a little bit of last minute preparation. Get your head in the right place, I think, is the most important thing. To get my scores in the right order, just check over them, make sure I know what's coming up. Make sure my baton is here and everything is where I left it.
Yesterday evening, we were greeted by a lot of downpours, showers, and a couple of interruptions. But however, being television, we were able to sort of get through all of that. Looks like we've got a really nice evening. The cloud cover is just right what we need here back at the castle, which maximises our lighting and the stage design that we have. So tonight is a real bonus for us.
When
We looked at a couple of things after last night's show, a little bit of choreography. We've done some more music rehearsals just to try and fine tune, just because we're all so fussy, we'd like to just get it exactly right.
They do make such a beautiful sound, you know, musically, and with a choir and an organ, full orchestra, it's going to be quite the night.
I think sometimes what people don't appreciate what goes on behind the scenes. I mean, there was quite an elaborate stage. There was a 32-piece orchestra. There was a 6-piece band, technicians, cameramen, and a choir, and an audience of 1,000 people. But it was worth it.
We're in a good position where we can look back and see what we've done and say, you know, yeah, you know, we're very proud of that. But there's still a lot of other things that we want to try and work into Celtic Woman, and we want the group to evolve. We want the girls to evolve with their singing and their playing, and we want the music to evolve. I suppose you always want it to stay the same, and yet you want it to be totally new. So whatever way you make those two things work is the little bit of magic that's there.
I hope you all, when you finally get to see this, will love and enjoy the DVD and the CD and enjoy the journey like we have.